years in Columbia, South Carolina. That's their winningest coach in school history, looking for a ninth win against the Gamecocks. But Shane Beamer got Clemson in Death Valley last time around, and he feels like it's a fair fight this year as light gives way tonight.
This is the Palmetto Bowl, the battle for the unofficial state championship.
We're keeping it street. We're keeping it street. I took a loss, but you still gonna get beat. You still gonna get beat.
Nothing is like this one.
That's probably what makes it different. It's just really personal.
Bragging rights on the line.
This is the best week of the year.
They hate you. That's just the way it is. It's a rivalry.
You're watching SEC Saturday Night, presented by T-Mobile 5G Home Internet. It is the state championship of South Carolina between number 24 Clemson and the South Carolina Gamecocks. Matt Stinchcomb, I'm Taylor Zarzer, Alyssa Lang's on the field. We've seen some incredible finishes in rivalry games. I promise you, the intensity in those games wasn't like it is in this building right now. It's electric. We've got current United States senators and governors and former presidents here tonight to watch this one, and it's the 120th time they played each other.
And there's a reason why they say you save the best for last. I mean, this is more than a rivalry. You share a state with your opponent here tonight. And you heard the coaches talk about it. It's not just proximity, it's personal in this one. Very excited to see these two teams.
Yeah, no national championship or conference championship to play for, just a state championship. In other words, it means everything. But Clemson's lost four games this year, and South Carolina was 2-6 at one point. But neither team has lost in November. What's changed? What's brought out their best football?
Yeah, both programs are peaking at just the right time. When you look at Clemson, they've minimized their catastrophic mistakes offensively, and they've been fueled by takeaways defensively, 10 of them in the last three wins. Then you look at South Carolina, they changed some of their defensive alignment, got more playmakers, more speed on that side of the ball. And the other piece of it is solidified that offensive front. For the fourth game in a row now, they will have the same offensive line roster, something that's been different for the entire season. It's been kind of a revolving door for the Gamecocks.
Well, you see it. The energy in this place is just electric. For more on it, let's go to the field and Alyssa Lang.
This might be the loudest stadium in America tonight, because in this state, it all comes down to this. Tonight, relationships will be tested, friendships strained, and families divided will decide if blood is thicker than a rivalry. There are no professional sports in this state, making this one mean so much more. Forget what happened in the first 11 games of your season. If you win this one, bragging rights reside in your city for the next 365 days. Can Spencer Rattler become the first quarterback in over a decade to win back-to-back games against Clemson? Can the Tigers avenge last year and be the door that stands in the way of the Gamecocks postseason? It's been over 100 years of hatred, and tonight it'll be on full display under the lights of Williams-Brice Stadium, right in the middle of a sandstorm.
Man, can you feel it? They played it more than Ohio State, Michigan, and the Iron Bowl. 120th meeting. We're looking at Robert Gunn, who's going to kick it to Xavier Leggett. Clemson won the toss and deferred. Gamecocks get it first. Alyssa just told you about Spencer Rattler. He's going to bring the Gamecocks out to the 25-yard line, and he should be second in South Carolina history in single-season passing yards by night's end. He's currently fifth, but he's going to work his way up the board if he gets over 133 yards tonight. He has had a fantastic year, and he's on everybody's NFL draft board. One thing to watch tonight is will he have to carry on Joyner? Joyner is banged up with an ankle injury. He wants to play. He's not out there on the first play. No Juice Wells tonight either. Still hurt with the injury. And on the first play, it's Rattler to Leggett. Stinch, we've been watching it all year. That one for 18 yards.
You know, it's interesting. Dabo Swinney talked about it. Leggett didn't even catch a pass against us last year. And now he is a superstar wide receiver. What a way to start the game for South Carolina offensively to get that combination going.
Swing it out. That ball could be a live ball. Is it a fumble? There's no ruling yet. That's Khalil Barnes going into the end zone. If it stands, it's a 43-yard return for a touchdown. The true freshman from Atlanta, Georgia, kept playing as there was no whistle.
We thought that what South Carolina would do in this game is try to move the line of scrimmage. That ball looks like it was very much thrown backwards. Live ball. Great job coming up by Makuba as he ends up tying up Leggett. Leggett knew that it was probably live. You can see him try to work his way back, and Barnes wisely scoops and scores. Already a quick swing. You get the big play on the first snap.
Running on the field was a backwards pass recovered by the defense for a touchdown. That play was under further review.
So very quickly, Mike Webster, tonight's ACC replay official, as you just saw Jeff Flanagan, the ACC referee, they'll take a look at this. But as you said, at first glance, it looked like it was going backwards.
Yeah, the other angle, and even live, it looked as if that ball was thrown backwards. You could see typically, but sometimes you can just take anecdotally the way that the intended receiver responds. Hard to tell from that angle. But you could see Leggett. Now, this one might be definitive.
Throws it from the 37 and a half. And Leggett looks like.
Oh, yeah.
He makes contact with it at the 37.
I think this is the look we saw earlier. That ball very much looks as if it is traveling backwards. And as we know, they allowed that play to play out. The play on the field was as if that were a live ball.
One thing both coaches agreed on in our meetings this week, turnovers have been a massive factor for both of these teams. South Carolina's 10-0 in the last 2 years at home. When they force a takeaway, they're 0-3 when they don't. Clemson, meanwhile, has had a disastrous year losing the football 20 times, but they've gained it 23 times, one of the top marks in all of college football.
Yeah, the defense for Clemson has really erased a lot of the giveaways. Tons of fumbles for the Clemson offense, but here's South Carolina. It seems as if gifting Clemson.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands for touchdown.
So Coach Sweeney and the Tigers get the turnover, a fumble recovery for a touchdown for the game's first score.
Taylor, we talked about it at the top. What's helped change the momentum for Clemson in this season? And a big part of it is the defense, not only getting key stops, it's been good all season, but those 10 turnovers, now 11, their last four times out.
Graduate school, Jonathan White's back to Clemson again, makes the extra point, and that's the fifth defensive touchdown for Dabo Swinney's team this season. Turn 54 this past Monday. 16th season as the Clemson head coach. Alabama somehow, his alma mater won, beat Auburn today. That ties Sweeney with the most Power 5 wins since 2013. This guy has a chance to do something pretty special too. Get to a bowl game for his third straight year in his first 3 years as a head coach of the Gamecocks. A lot of adversity at 2-6, but won 3 in a row. And we'll do it again. This time, Clemson up 7-0.
Chance Xavier Leggett deep for South Carolina. He's already caught a pass and was targeted on that second one. Early calamity. How does South Carolina respond?
first play, Rattler, an 18-yard completion, but then the fumble on the second play. A rivalry that Clemson has owned for over 100 years. You see their record against the Gamecocks. All the meetings in either Clemson or Columbia. Of course, they only played in Columbia until the early 1960s. And last year, South Carolina ended Clemson's 40-game home winning streak, which was the eighth longest in college football history. What an epic game they had in Death Valley last year. Rattler threw for 360 yards in that one. He fakes to Mario Anderson, has plenty of time. He's got somebody down there deep, and it's intercepted. That's Barnes again. He was trying to squeeze it into Amarian Brown, but Barnes had him covered up.
Come back, an aggressive play call off a heavy play action on a first down. And Spencer Rattler hangs it up, puts the ball in jeopardy. What a start for Barnes and this Clemson defense. Two takeaways, one touchdown.
Four seconds of football. Khalil Barnes already has a fumble recovery for a touchdown and an interception. And now his offensive teammates take the field for the first time tonight. Kate Klupnik, who's been handing it off all season, gives it to Phil Maffa. And Maffa will only get one, maybe two. Klupnik, of course, the sophomore from Austin, Texas, in at quarterback. He started every game this year. And he's broken out in November, played his best football, especially the last 2 weeks against Georgia Tech and North Carolina. Maffa, up past the 40, it'll be third down.
Now, one of the things Clemson coveted when they brought in Garrett Riley, they wanted to run the football. That is something that has been a strength down the stretch. Gotten away from more dangerous plays in the passing game. The other piece of it is you're running in South Carolina now. This front just has three big bodies along their front. They're 3-3. There are gaps to run into.
Johnson got to him, the senior.
So here's Johnson, a little bit of confusion. He's just going to come right upfield. Watches Blake Miller. He kicks wide, and there's just confusion because of Debo Williams blitzing right there, occupying Harris Sewell at right guard. That gave a free run for Tyreek Johnson.
Just like that, the Gamecock defense forces a three and out. Aiden Swanson's been terrific punting the football for Clemson. Jalen Kilgore waiting on it. It's a short punt, but takes a Clemson bounce. Kilgore goes nowhere on a 49-yard punt. Gamecocks, two turnovers and down seven early.
SEC Saturday Night is presented by T-Mobile 5G Home Internet, connecting homes across the SEC, and in part by Mercedes-Benz. The holiday love celebration is here, now through January 2nd.
They celebrate how much they hate each other by setting things on fire here in the Palmetto State. It's been going on for over 120 years. South Carolina is about to have their third possession just a couple minutes into the game. Clemson has now forced a 12th turnover, an 11th and a 12th turnover in their last 13 quarters. Spencer Rattler needs to calm down this Gamecock offense. And he'll try Mario Anderson, the Division II transfer from Newberry College, who's had a solid season running for nearly 700 yards. He'll get one there.
Yeah, I don't expect we're going to see a steady diet of run game. versus this Clemson front. Big physical front, not a lot of running room, but given the way this game has started for South Carolina, makes sense to maybe take the ball out of Rattler's hands to get this series started.
Rattler pocket collapsing, throws underneath, incomplete, but there is a flag down. He was trying to get it to Joshua Simon, covered up by Barrett
Personal
Carter.
Foul. Roughing the passer, number 54. The 15-yard penalty, first down.
That's on the terrific linebacker, Jeremiah Trotter, Jr.
The Clemson's able to bring five on almost every passing down. So Jeremiah Trotter, yeah, hit him high. As Rattler was trying to, he got a jump pass. You see it? Where it's not like he was baiting as if he was going to run up. But a great job by...
That was not Trotter that hit him. That was Xavier Thomas. He got his hand up there.
Yep.
So he identified the wrong player. Nevertheless, he gives South Carolina the ball at the 35. Fake to Brown. Spencer will run. Breaking tackles and a first down run into Clemson territory. Barrett Carter couldn't get his hand on him. 17 yards.
We thought that they would probably run Rattler more in this game. Really did a great job of breaking a tackle. Got a pull with authority. Javon Ball just kind of slammed on the brakes.
Lots of eye candy, and that is Dakarion Joyner. And he is playing the super senior with a hurt ankle a few weeks ago against Jacksonville State. Has been pleading with coaches this week. You see him grimacing there.
Yeah.
He told Alyssa on the field, I have to go tonight. And there he is, picking up five.
Look in that backfield, that's Xavier Leggett.
Leaving the backfield, catching the ball, and holding on to it, but holding his knee. And that's the last thing Gamecocks fans want to see. Shane Beamer runs out to check on it.
Was a low tackle by Wiggins. Clean tackle, but you see Leggett's out there in bike shorts. Boom, gets a helmet right on his left knee. I don't know if he hyperextended it or not. We noted that in pregame. We've seen a lot of short pants this year, but these are literally cut off mid-thigh. And I don't know if it was just the blow that bothered him. You hope that he's not injured. One of the best performers in the SEC. Did look as if that left leg hyperextended a little bit maybe, but he's got a lot of weight on it right now on the sideline. This is a guy that's been battling through injuries all season long. But South Carolina cannot afford to lose him. Lined up in the backfield there, does so much for this offense.
Leggett leaves. Anderson comes back in as Rattler's in pistol set. Quick throw to Knox, and Knox is tackled at the line of scrimmage. How about Joyner playing through injury tonight, Alyssa?
Taylor, you talked about it, what he said pregame. Someone who spent 6 years here at this university, who's given everything, changed positions. He said, I don't feel 100%, but there was no way I was missing this one.
And now Knox is down too. Trey has missed some time this year due to injury, just like Joyner has.
Back-to-back plays. Nate Wiggins coming up. Cut tackles. On the previous one, it was on Leggett. Sent Leggett to the sideline. And now you see Trey Knox holding that right knee. It's braced. You see that nice shot right there on his inside knee. Gets the receiver down on the ground. But you can see Knox grimacing. And he is clearly more affected than Leggett was.
Leggett's back on the field. And Knox is going into the tent after those consecutive Wiggins low tackles. What a game Nate had last week against UNC. Second and 10, South Carolina at the Clemson 39. Anderson. Big hole. Down near the 20.
A great cut by Anderson. See him read the flow. It's just a zone to the left. And he's able to undercut Barrett Carter, who was coming upfield too far.
19 yards for Mario. Twisting and turning and maybe gets a yard there. His story is remarkable. He's averaging over 5 yards per carry. He's a nominee for the Burlesworth Award for a former walk-on player. and over 1,500 yards rushing for Newberry College last year, and now he's a starting tailback in the SEC. Leaves the backfield here on a 2nd and 9. Rattler gets rid of it quickly. Inside the 10 to Joshua Simon, 1st and goal, Gamecocks.
You see Rattler walk up to the line of scrimmage. He knew he was going to be hot. Had a free blitzer from the right side of the formation. Gets the ball out quickly. Great awareness pre-snap of understanding the defense. As soon as they went to that empty backfield.
With Knox out, you can expect to see a lot of Joshua Simon, South Carolina's other tight end. So again, moving to the top of your screen in the slot. Anderson gets the corner inside the 5.
Nice job by the left side of South Carolina's offensive front. Great job capturing the edge. Battle of the day, true freshman, forced into service to play that left tackle spot, was able to get Anderson downhill. On nice runs. We've seen some with one on a cutback, and that time right at the point of attack to the edge of this Clemson defensive front.
You've seen defensive players playing offense for the Gamecocks when they get near the goal line. They're not in there at least yet. 2nd and goal. Rattler throws to the 1, and Leggett is held out on a nice tackle by the true freshman, Avion Terrell.
Yeah, the ball kind of turned Leggett around. Watch it. The ball ends up stopping him. He had to slam on brakes.
Gamecocks go quickly on the 3rd and goal at the 1. And it doesn't appear as they got in.
Like you said, Taylor, short. They tried to jump it. They tried to jump over the ball quickly and catch Clemson on their heels. Instead, that front was able to burrow down. Did not get a lot of surge.
Gamecocks are just 7 of 20 on 4th down. This is 4th and goal inside the 1 on the 11th play of the drive.
You see Dabo Swinney was all the way down inside the 5-yard line to get a timeout so his defense can talk about it.
Well, now that Spencer Rattler can go to the sideline and talk to Shane Beamer. Of course, his offensive coordinator, Dowell Loggins, is upstairs. Don't be surprised if they try to fool Clemson and Wes Goodwin, the defensive coordinator, Dabo Swinney, with some defensive linemen.
Yeah.
Tonka Hemingway and Alex Huntley have both scored touchdowns for South Carolina this month. They're both defensive linemen.
One is a runner and one is a receiver. They're not even exclusively being handed the football. Bell Loggins has had to be creative this season. Not only is the offensive line shuffled, the wide receiving core has not always been healthy. You mentioned no Wells tapped out after that Georgia game. Haven't seen him since. Leggett has ascended. They've had others to emerge. We saw a little bit of Lenoris Sellers last year in the red zone as well. Rattler still in there at quarterback.
None of those defensive linemen are out there on this 4th and goal from the 1. That's Leggett. Pop pass. Now it's Harbor. The true freshman cuts it back. Touchdown! Luke Doty is the man that got it. Doty on the end around. Receiver turns into a runner on a reverse. Mitch Jeter ties it up. Spencer Rattler had 2 turnovers in the first 2 drives. He goes on a 12-play drive, and his backup quarterback scores the touchdown. Tie game in Columbia.
Oh, my world, stand still.
Columbia for a decade. In fact, South Carolina just scored its first touchdown at home against Clemson since 2017. 35-3 and 30-0 the last two times Clemson has played the Gamecocks here. But South Carolina marches down the field on a 12-play drive, 49 of those yards on the ground. Tied up at 7 apiece. You got to check this off your list. If you've never been to Williams-Brice on a Saturday night. Clemson will get it at the 25. Dari Noka gets into the studio right now.
All right, TZ, we update. You know, teams have just been trying to survive over the course of the day, and they have to this point. If you're in the championship hunt, but Florida State in a bit of a bind, down 7-0 to the Gators, Montrell Johnson there. Georgia down to Georgia Tech moments ago. Carson Beck to Dominic Lovett. They're tied at 7 in Atlanta, guys.
Okay, so Dogs and Yellow Jackets tied at 7. Gators up 10-0 on the Noles. And Alabama wins. Another shocking ending on the Plains. Kolubnik gives to Maffa, and Maffa goes ahead near the 30-yard line. Seen a lot of him on the first two drives. He's kind of the starter, the tailback for Clemson. He had 36 carries 2 weeks ago against Georgia Tech, but you will see a lot of Will Shipley tonight, too. Those two guys have been terrific as the identity of Clemson's offense this year. Neither in the backfield. Well, nope, here comes Shipley. And Klubnik will run it. Ran it well against the Tar Heels last week, and he picks up a first down here.
Something they talked about doing more. The Clemson coaches saying getting Klubnik going in the run game. Here they do so early. Will Shipley, you saw him shift into the backfield, a guy that figures pretty prominently in the passing game. Excellent receiver out of the backfield, a guy that they'll try to get him to the, get him the ball downfield at times. Now again, Clemson starting this snap with an empty formation in the backfield.
Klubnik throws, and it's an underneath ball, and it's caught by Adam Randall, one of the few, that's Brown, Tyler Brown that caught it. Brown, the true freshman, sixth most catches by a freshman in college football this year, and he's been the most dependable they have due to all the injuries they have at wide receiver.
Yeah, as you mentioned earlier, Taylor, no Bo Collins, top receiving target, one of the more electric players for Clemson offensively, not available due to an injury to his foot. Won't be playing here tonight for Clemson on that side of the ball.
It's only a pickup of 3. Shipley leaves the backfield. They swing it out to him. And he's tackled up near the 45 by O'Donnell Fortune, who's back tonight after missing the game last week due to team violations. It's third down.
A challenge all game long, really, for both these defenses. These offenses will move the line of scrimmage. Get the ball to a playmaker quickly near the line of scrimmage. Try to block out in front with your receivers. And this third and short, South Carolina stays in their 3 down front. Just 3 big bodies.
It's Maffa. First down Clemson, their first of the night, and into Gamecocks territory.
Well, the challenge is, you take one of those big D linemen off the field, you're asking somebody oftentimes to play 2 gaps on a downhill run.
Klubnik, as the Clemson Tigers go quickly, he goes quickly, marching inside the 45 near the 42, where Stone Blanton tackles the sophomore quarterback from Austin, Texas. Interceptions and fumbles, a big part of his story the first couple of months. He's been smarter with the football these last few weeks. Clemson's had over 400 yards of total offense in the wins against Georgia Tech and North Carolina. Shipley, terrific junior tailback next to him. Play clock inside of 5. Klubnik has all day. but eventually flushed out. And now we'll run for a first down.
That time South Carolina twisted their rush. I mean, they had their offensive line, defensive linemen swapping gaps. You see Sanders come out. He ends up getting the initial pressure, and Klubnik just turns his back to the line of scrimmage. He's able to escape. It's all the way downfield. And so far in this possession, it's been Cade Klubnik and his ability to run with the football that's fueled this drive.
This one snapped just inside the South Carolina 35. Another quick throw and a nice tackle made as Brown makes the catch. Bam Martin Scott right there, loss of three.
But Taylor, we talked about this at the top. One of the reasons that South Carolina made some changes, they needed more explosive playmaking on defense. Bam Martin Scott was a big part of that. They needed a guy that could come up and strike. Quick ID, great diagnosis. Already his fourth tackle of the game. Very active for number 22.
On second and 13, it's Maffa. He'll get near the 33. It'll be third and long. This could be four down territory for Dabo Swinney. Kicking has been a problem all year. Tigers just 9 of 18 kicking field goals.
See Shipley subbing into the lineup. The challenge has been with no Bo Collins. You've got two knowns at receiver. Tyler Brown, Jake Brenningstuhl, the tight end.
Klubnik has time to throw as the receiver intercepted. Fortune dropped it.
Wow. What a miss by Fortune. As this ball hangs up there. Trying to get it to Troy Stellato. Came all the way from underneath. Fortune dropped underneath this pass. DQ Smith at safety over the top and just drops a certain interception.
Well, I said that it might be four down territory. Instead, here comes Jonathan White's his career long is 41. This is 50 yards for the graduate player from Charleston. And White's nails it. Given all of this man has been through this year with the miss against Florida State to take the lead, how good does that feel against your arch rival, a 50-yarder? Dabo Swinney loves it.
Well, he's got to be fired up, right? You think about the struggles all season long with place kicking. Boy, South Carolina got through there. Lucky that thing wasn't blocked. Instead, he stripes one right between the uprights.
Youngest son Clay Sweeney with a great hold, and White's with a perfect kick. That's got to feel good for Dabo, who convinced him to leave grad school, come back to school. He's had all these ups and downs, and he gives Clemson the lead again.
You think about that drop by Fortune, a three-point swing at least, right? You're underneath that ball, have both hands on it, got to come up with that stop for your defense, and instead, you fire up the opposing team's sideline. Dabo Swinney, that unlocks your decision-making when you're in the plus side of the field. Like you mentioned, Taylor, I thought the same thing. It's probably four down territory.
Well, that guy kicking off, Robert Gunn, of course, was the man that he beat out is this kick front gun. All he does is kick off now. It goes out of bounds. South Carolina will get it at the 35.
You know, it'll sound crazy as you look at the scoreboard, you think about the two takeaways already for Clemson, but you think about it, we'll say it's fluky, but Leggett drops that backwards pass, you get a scoop and score. So you're almost shocked to the system. The very next play, the next possession, you hang one out. Barnes gets a pick. The South Carolina went right down the field on Clemson.
Rattler hands to Anderson. might have lost half a yard. By the way, Rattler already passed Steve Tannehill for fourth in South Carolina season passing numbers. What a season Spencer has had leading the charge for the Gamecocks. He was 15-2 at Oklahoma, 13-11 for the Gamecocks, but says it's the best decision he ever made. He throws this one-on-one ball to the sideline, and Leggett can't grab it as Wiggins was all over him. Third down.
Well, Clemson, they play rolled up tight a lot of the game, and they're physical off the line. These guys are not scared to mix it up with the receivers. Leggett, as big and strong as he is, Wiggins, a big long corner.
And of course, Trey Knox is not out there now, Alyssa.
That guy's getting injured after that last South Carolina drive. It looks like they put a brace on that knee. I've been watching him on the sidelines. He's been trying to run it out, but been limping and grimacing in pain just a bit.
Instead, Joshua Simon, the backup tight end, could be counted on. Rattler gets out of the pocket, runs, dragging Tigers, and it's a first down. Peter Woods was on Rattler, couldn't get him to the ground, and Rattler gives the Gamecocks a fresh set of downs at the end of the first quarter. One of the best environments in college football, watching one of the best rivalries tonight. As we start the second quarter, they were reviewing this play to see if Spencer Rattler, in fact, got a first down. As you can see, his left knee was down, half a yard shy of the first, so they just overturned that call. And the Gamecocks will have a fourth and one instead of a first down. They do have it at the Clemson 44-yard line. Actually, was switching sides, rather. It's their own 44-yard line.
South Carolina already 1-for-1 on fourth down here tonight with the Luke Doty reverse. Would-be pass. End up just tucking it and running it go in for the touchdown. We're here on the minus side of the field. And we've seen already these quarterbacks, their running ability figuring prominently. Cade Klubnik fueling the previous drive, resulting in that Clemson field goal. Spencer Rattler on that scramble. Looks like he's, as we mentioned, just shy with this fourth down attempt. South Carolina still huddled near their sideline.
With their offensive players.
Yeah.
And out comes Rattler. Need to get to the 45-yard line, and you see that ball is about 2 feet short of it. Anderson behind Rattler. And Mario looked like the first effort got right to the 45 and right to that yellow line. Let's see where they spot it.
Man, what a collision. It was Jeremiah Trotter. He worked his way through the traffic and met Anderson. It's 54. 54 and 24, right at the 45-yard line. And the far down marker's already flipped over to first down.
Yeah, Dabo doesn't look happy with the result.
It was quite a collision. One of the best linebackers in the game, the Butkus finalist. Boom. See Barnes coming in there to try to finish it up.
Ball made the 45-yard line. It's a first down.
Quite the effort by Anderson. Coach Sweeney's over there. He's trying to get the attention of the officials still.
What do you think? The ball went out of bounds on the kickoff, right? So it gives you the ball at the 35. You had to get to the 45, and that's exactly where Anderson was stopped. He stopped this time at the 49 as Xavier Thomas wrestles him to the ground.
The Henderson's had some success, as we mentioned on the previous drive. Able to get the ball going on the ground. This is not necessarily, and he's looked a little wobbly when he got up.
Player injury.
Well, Thomas slammed him down pretty hard.
Yeah, now they'll tend to him. He's been banged up in recent weeks. Their only healthy scholarship tailback is freshman DJ Braswell, with two other South Carolina tailbacks banged up too.
You see how Xavier Thomas makes this tackle on Mario Anderson. Boom. Finish him right into the ground. And you can see Anderson's helmet made contact with the turf. And you can see trying to work those pads, but a little wobbly. You see Spencer Rattler's like, no, you're not right, bud. Get down. Anderson back out on the field.
Well, he took his helmet off. This is DJ Braswell's stench that comes in. He's the only healthy tailback the Gamecocks have left. Juju McDowell lost for the season 2 weeks ago. DK Joyner hurt his ankle, and you saw how limited he is. Braswell will go off, and Anderson now will come back into the game on a third down for South Carolina. Rattler facing pressure, and that ball is deflected at the line. Xavier Thomas pressured Rattler. It's fourth down.
Great job by Thomas. We mentioned him earlier. He got his hand on Rattler's arm. It was just enough to force a bad throw. And South Carolina staying aggressive here at midfield. The offense is out there on this fourth down.
Gamecocks are 0 of 3 on third down, but 2 of 2 on fourth. Jumps, it is a first down, and it looks like that's what the Gamecocks are trying to do.
Trey Knox back in the lineup, was in that previous snap as well, and South Carolina looking like they could just trying to steal a first down there.
Just a reminder after this game between Clemson and South Carolina, join the SEC football final crew with Dari Restoring Benjamin Watson immediately after the game to recap all the biggest football storylines and highlights from the weekend. I wish we were filming us watching the end of the Iron Bowl with that man hovering over my shoulder and Wes Goodwin, the defensive coordinator for Clemson, trying to jump in and watch it too. Rivalry weekend never disappoints. So Kai Kroger, who's been known to fake it, will punt it away this time. It's caught at the 11. And Clemson will get it back on offense with 13:29 to go until halftime.
Dorian Oke in studio. It is time for the road to the championship presented by Mercedes-Benz. Of course, Georgia getting ready for Alabama next week, but down 14-10 before Kendall Milton punches it in. They lead Tech 14-10. They were down 10-7. By the way, Florida leads Florida State 12-0 at the moment, guys.
Dari, we've got all kinds of superstars in the building tonight here in Clemson, here in Columbia, South Carolina, with Clemson here. Look at that. Henry McMaster, the governor of South Carolina, with his guest tonight, the former president of the United States, Donald Trump. Lindsey Graham, U.S. Senator here in South Carolina, is here in the game tonight. Frank Beamer, of course, is always here watching his son, Shane, coach the Gamecocks. A lot of firepower in the building to watch the state championship of South Carolina. Will Shipley run all over South Carolina the last 2 years. 100-plus yard performances as a freshman and a sophomore. Carries ahead near a first down, and the Tigers will go quickly. And Shipley, following that big offensive line, moves the chains for a first. Shipley, the junior from Weddington, North Carolina, only a junior stench. He needs 124 yards to pass Woody Dantzler for 10th in school history. To give you an idea how good he's been in two-plus years.
There's a legendary name for you, Woody Dantzler. And the run game has to get going for Clemson. When you think about it, they've only thrown it three times. Two completions for Klubnik, but should have an interception. Dangerous decision-making. Opportunity versus South Carolina defensively if they can get their ground game established.
Shipley for a third straight play. Doesn't get much. Bam Martin Scott comes in to make the tackle. Shipley did miss the Notre Dame game. He was in concussion protocol for the Georgia Tech game. He got hurt in the Notre Dame game. You never would have known it last week. He had 126 yards against the Tar Heels.
It just showed how versatile of a talent he is. We've already seen him here today demonstrating his pass-catching ability. A guy that can help this offense in a variety of ways. You have to know where and how he can hurt you.
Klubnik will throw this time. Instead, he'll step up and run and gets tripped up short of the first down by Jordan Strawn. Debo Williams as well. It's third down.
And another scramble from Klubnik. Nice coverage downfield. South Carolina has struggled for stretches this season defensively in the pass game. They feel as if they've made the right changes, especially with Nick Eamon-Worre and DQ Smith permanently at the safety spot. Jalen Kilgore now in the slot as the nickelback.
Shipley out of the backfield, makes the catch, stays in bounds, first down Clemson.
We just got done talking about how Will Shipley, an explosive runner, no doubt, but so dangerous out of the backfield. Just swing him out there. Lay that ball in front of him and let him run through the catch. Pretty acrobatic finish to that run after catch.
Maffa and Shipley both on the field here, and it's Shipley following Maffa. And he'll get a couple up to the 37 where Debo Williams tackles him. You know, Stinch, Maffa and Shipley both have over 700 yards rushing. There are only three teams in college football that have two running backs that have over 700 yards. Florida, San Jose State are the other teams, and it's pick your poison with those guys.
And they ham and egg it pretty well. It's Maffa in there now for this second down. Very similar, though. It's not like it's a huge distinction between the two as runners.
Klubnik throw out of the backfield, incomplete. He was trying to get it to Jake Brenningstuhl for the first time tonight, but Nick Eamon-Worre was all over it.
As you mentioned, first target for Brenningstuhl. Eamon-Worre, probably the most athletic defender South Carolina has. He's huge at 6'3". He's 6'4 if he's an inch. 220 pounds. Matches well with the 6'6 Brenningstuhl. South Carolina's had some success getting to Klubnik.
On third and eight, Klubnik pressured. Throws underneath, Maffa catches it, and he's short. DQ Smith with the open field tackle.
Once again, South Carolina able to get Klubnik off his spot. Smith at the top of his drop. Great job by Tonka Hemingway just running the arc. Ends up dumping it off to Maffa. DQ Smith, just got set gun, talking about him as his comfort zone at safety. Makes the nice open field tackle.
Jalen Kilgore down there, ready to receive this punt from Aiden Swanson. Swanson with another really good punt, and it's dropped, and Kilgore gets back on it. Swanson has the most punts inside the 20 in school history in a season. That's his 21st on the year. South Carolina lucky they didn't just cough up turnover number three. Let's take a look at Fansville, brought to you by Dr. Pepper.
Trash.
Delusional.
Doo-doo.
Trash.
Losers.
Disgusting. Losers.
Sad.
Sad.
We asked for one word to describe your rival, and that's what we got. From the Catanese's to the Mackey's, from the Smiths to the Davies families, don't like each other. Clemson and Carolina families on this night are all 365 days of the year, and that play destined to fail is Mario Anderson covered up by Jeremiah Trotter. It's a loss of six.
That one got sniffed out pretty quickly. Tried to get a blocker out there. Clemson did a good job fighting through it. No room to run. Excellent punt. You know, South Carolina backed up now in the field position battle. Good job by the defense getting the ball back for their offense. They got to pick a first down up.
Anderson started his move from his own goal line and he didn't get much. In fact, he lost yardage. Was T.J. Parker, who leads the country for true freshmen in tackles for loss. He now has 10 and a half.
Talk about knockback. That's what defensive lines want to do. They'll knock that offensive line back, and it forces the running back to bubble their run. They can't attack the line of scrimmage. They have to lose ground first. That's exactly what happened on Mario Anderson on that second down run.
Got to get to the upstate to get a first down. Third and 18 is dropped. Anderson can't make the catch. And that is a quick three and out for the South Carolina offense, losing 8 yards.
A missed opportunity that time. Nick Harbor on a shallow cross, just drag all the way across the field, was open. Rattler had already come back to Anderson to check it down. Big stop down there for Clemson. Stop this offense, get the ball back with what should be excellent field position.
Yeah, that's Hamp Green standing in Gamecock territory, and Kai Kroger's almost at the back of his end zone. It's a short punt. Green at the 44 calls for a fair catch. Excellent field position for Clemson, who got two turnovers in less than a minute, both by Khalil Barnes, recovering that lateral for a touchdown to start the scoring. Then on the next play, he picks Spencer Rattler off. Gamecocks on their third drive do go down the field. Luke Doty on a fourth and goal from the one on a reverse, scoring the touchdown. Clemson has tacked on a field goal, and now they're in Gamecock territory to start this drive.
By far the best starting field position. If you don't want to count a scoop and score, offense didn't even have to take the field. The offense has been slowed, though, tonight.
Klubnik has time, throws too high over the middle, looking for Brenningstuhl.
Three South Carolina defenders in the area, too. That ball sailed high, maybe a blessing. That ball was a little bit lower. You see three defenders converging underneath, one underneath, two over top.
Just got to wonder about the confidence level Klubnik has in his receivers. Brenningstuhl's his favorite. He's been relying on him all year, but all the other pass catchers have been banged up for Clemson this year. A couple of them not playing tonight. This is Shipley. He's been old reliable. He only gets about a yard there as Bam Martin Scott said one whale of a first half. Debo Williams in there too.
The South Carolina linebacking core has started this game very strongly. There's a lot more pressure and burden given the type of alignment that they're playing in. Just the three bigs, the three linebackers behind them. They have to come up and make those fits along the line of scrimmage. Empty backfield. We mentioned earlier, South Carolina has gotten to Klubnik on these third downs and obvious passing situations.
It is loud in here. Third and 9, Klubnik throws. It's underneath Shipley. First down, down near the Gamecocks 32.
That time South Carolina only rushed three, but it's a tunnel. So watch Shipley. He just kind of delays a little bit. The offensive lineman released downfield. Easy conversion, timely call that time.
False start. Offense number 55. 5-yard penalty. First down.
True freshman Harris Sewell's had a great year at right guard. Clemson only has one senior on this offense. It's the man that lines up next to Sewell, Will Putnam, who is playing in a record 59th game tonight. That's a record for Clemson offensive lineman passing Mitch Hyatt. But unless someone goes pro, like Trent Howard, the left guard, Clemson gets all these guys back next year.
A lot of young contributors for Clemson, and some that we have not seen much this year.
Play clock was running out. It's Garrett Riley, 34-year-old first-year offensive coordinator. They call it Clemson Dirt Raid that he's in charge of with the Clemson offense.
Welcome in. Region's Halftime Report coming up. Dari Doering and Watson, an Iron Bowl for the ages. We will walk you through what happened there. Jordan-Hare, also Georgia, in a battle that not many saw coming here. What do you see from South Carolina?
Feels a little like last week, right? South Carolina's defense holding them in there.
Two critical turnovers, 0-4 on third down. It's not a recipe for success.
All right, we'll see you all in just a few.
Not a lot of passing yards, gentlemen, either. Neither quarterback has 30 yards passing yet. Klubnik has plenty of time to throw, and it's caught. Brown might have rather let that drop, but he makes the catch, a freshman.
Not a lot of passing yards mentioned. Really, we haven't seen many passes go downfield. The two that we have, both should have been intercepted. One was on the third play of the game by Clemson. The other missed by South Carolina. When the ball's been in the air, when it's been pushed downfield, it's been dangerous.
Second and 10. Klubnik throws, incomplete, dropped. He had his big freshman tight end Olsen, Pat Henry, wide open.
We're talking about some guys that have had to play more. The tight ends are going to get more targets. That time Blant was underneath it, and I think probably just disrupted Olsen, Pat Henry's view of that ball.
Only has one catch on the year as Shipley came up to give him an attaboy. It's third and 10 now.
Last time we saw a screen pass on a third and 10 to Shipley, South Carolina only rushed three on that down.
Klubnik, pressure, throws. Did that ball get back to the line of scrimmage? The Gamecocks certainly don't think so. Beamer and his staff need about 10 get-back guys right now.
The passer was outside the tackle box. Ball crossed the line of scrimmage. It's an incomplete pass.
They're going to say that Klubnik was able to escape the tackle box.
And that it got past the line of scrimmage. Let's watch this view here.
It was like a punt. It's hard to tell where that ball crosses the boundary.
It's a big call because that allows Jonathan Whites to come back onto the field and attempt another long field goal. He's made from 50 already. Clay Sweeney's going to sit down at the 39, so that makes this a 49-yard attempt. And Jonathan Whites having a night in Columbia.
Fans not happy. They felt as if that should have been intentional grounding. It looked almost as if Dabo Sweeney, right before that kick, ran down to try to get a timeout called. He just didn't get it there. Watch him. He's hustling down to the lineman. He's trying to get a timeout. The ball was already snapped. Dabo almost iced his own kicker.
He's glad he didn't. Whites was just one of six from 40-plus coming into tonight's game, and he has a 49-yarder and a 50-yarder so far in the game.
Well, we were down there on the field pregame watching him kick, and he was swinging through the ball well. And he nailed one from 59 in warm-ups. Now, it doesn't matter. You got to do it in a crowd. He's nailed two of them at the Frosted Tips to prove it.
This season, for every field goal, an extra point made by participating universities. Allstate will make a contribution to the university's general scholarship fund. Thank you, Allstate. Two of those go towards what Jonathan Whites has done tonight. Sure, his dad Jonathan and mom Lisa are going crazy after the two big kicks he's made. Clemson up 13-7, and the Gamecocks are coming out. This is Leggett. On his feet. And out of bounds, a late flag comes down.
I wonder, you know, earlier in the return, it looked like they got Leggett's face mask, but it didn't see a flag come out at that point.
During the return, holding 41, return 10, a 10-yard penalty, first down.
Ends up being a hold on South Carolina. Watch Leggett as he comes out of this crowd. Nah, he just got spun around by his shoulder pads. And it looks like
41, Andrew Calicerto.
Yeah. Kate Denhoff kind of threw his arms up. Sometimes those defenders, they throw those arms up. That's a little indicator for holding. Maybe some acting in that one.
That's what Leggett was known for before this year, being a terrific kick returner. Now he's one of the best receivers in the game. Rattler in trouble, gets rid of it.
We talked about coming into this game, Clemson's ability to pressure a passer. It's because they have this luxury. Oftentimes, they can bring five. They win right there. Xavier Thomas was able to get upfield, move Rattler off his spot. He had Leggett coming across. So often this season, that's been the case.
Wade Woodaz in his face stench as he threw it to the bench. On a second and 10, it's Anderson. Mario will work for a few. Another third down for this Gamecocks offense. They're 0-4 on this down tonight.
Both these offenses, they've wanted to establish the runs. When you think about when they've been able to move the ball, they got it going on the ground. Clemson largely with Klubnik in the scramble game, but South Carolina was able to get Anderson going earlier.
Rattler throws, incomplete. Harbor can't grab it. He was covered up by Avion Terrell. Fourth down.
Another quick stop by the Clemson defense. Pressure again right up the middle, and Harbor got to come up with that catch. Right in the hands. Terrell, who's given up about, I don't know, half a foot to Nick Harbor, who is a unit. That time just could not come up with a catch coming across. Would have been enough.
Kai Kroger, this will be his third punt. Hamp Green is waiting for the fair catch. Clemson will start this possession at the 22-yard line after a 45-yard punt.
Wherever fun happens, Academy Sports and Outdoors is there.
Taylor Zarzer, Matt Stinchcomb, Melissa Lang, and Williams-Brice Stadium for the 120th state championship of South Carolina. Butler, Buckholz, The Brawl, Beamer, Tannehill, Black Magic. So many memorable moments in this rivalry. What do we get in this one tonight? Hoffa gets up near the 25-yard line. Hoffa and Shipley, the identity of this Clemson offense, Alyssa.
They've been roommates since freshman year, guys. They consider each other's brothers, quote, until the very end, and they live by the phrase, iron sharpens iron. The better one is, the better it forces the other to be.
Second and 7 out of the backfield. This ball thrown by Klubnik. And it's caught there by Adam Randall. Randall, one of the many Clemson receivers, has been banged up. He's been playing with a big club on his hand, but he doesn't have it on tonight. He's just wearing normal gloves.
So he's got a broken bone in his hand. So he practices even better with that club on. So Will Shipley substituting in late. Shipley up here at the top of your screen, right there.
On third and 2, Club
Resnick on a design run has the first down, taking on Gamecocks. So he ran right into Elijah Davis. First down.
Well, they blow Shipley. Get that attention, right? You see the defenders talking about it. Design QB run all the way. Klubnik able to get just enough to get the conversion.
Clemson with 65 rushing yards so far. This ball thrown on the slant, but incomplete to Brown.
It's a couple now we've seen. Nick Harbor, you got to come up with a catch. We talked about the passing yards, and then there, Brown, come up with a catch for your quarterback. Stabs one in there. Both these offenses, receivers got to help their passers out.
I just wonder what Clemson's season would have looked like if Antonio Williams, Bo Collins, and Cole Turner all could have been healthy this year. Instead, it's Ben Brown most of the time getting the catches. This time in the backfield, he's going to lose yardage as Fortune was there on him.
Wow, what a play by O'Donnell Fortune. He diagnoses this play and then defeats the block almost immediately. An excellent job of getting upfield. No chance. And Troy Stellato, he had inside leverage on Stellato right now. Did a great job of getting upfield.
You'd never know that the home team is 5-6 with how loud it is in here tonight. Maffa, nowhere to go. Alex Boogie Huntley and friends make the tackle, forcing another Clemson punt, and South Carolina will call timeout.
Trying to preserve some of that clock and time to work with, a chance to get it with decent field position. Both defenses starting to show up. You think about six of the Clemson points. You know, one field goal should have been a pick. The other easily could have been. It was narrowly not intentional grounding. Otherwise, we're talking about a tie ball game right now.
Yeah, the turnovers have been a big factor, but game really feels stenched like it's been played in a phone booth. Neither team has 100 total yards.
It's been really quiet when you think about it. Well, one of those, right, the scoop and score, short field, second play of the game. The only touchdown for Clemson in this contest so far. South Carolina was able to march it down. They were aided by a roughing the passer penalty. Otherwise, it's been very quiet. As you mentioned, Taylor, kind of played between the 20s in this game.
Aiden Swanson punting it to Kilgore. Short kick. Kilgore fields at the 35. Stays on his feet past the 40, and South Carolina trying to get in position to get some points here before the end of the half. Clemson will get it first in the third quarter. These are the numbers for Rattler and for Klubnik. Just 29 yards passing for one of the best quarterbacks in college football this year, Spencer Rattler. And remember, 19 of those came on the first play of the game.
Yeah, right now, both quarterbacks really have almost more rushing yards than they do passing yards.
Spencer moves the pocket, throws underneath. Anderson again breaks a tackle and gets out of bounds.
A great effort by Anderson. That ball turned him around. And able to kind of skip and tippy-toe out of that first would-be tackler. Able to get upfield, get out of bounds, preserve some clock. South Carolina with the timeout in its back pocket.
Clemson defense, one of the 10 best in college football statistically, one of the 8th best against the pass. It's been on display in this first half. Rattler on a 2nd and 5, tries to get out of pressure, swinged around, throws. Catch made by Brown at the 37.
What an effort by Spencer Rattler. One of the most pressured quarterbacks in the entire conference, spins out of that one and delivered a strike, but I don't know that Brown's left knee wasn't down out of bounds first.
Previous plays on further review.
It was a great effort, but Shane Beamer wants to run with the referee, Jeff Lanigan, to take a look at it. Shane's moving around pretty good. He broke a bone in his foot
few weeks ago in frustration. He's been taped up before the games.
Let's see if it's definitive. You know, what they're looking at is, does Brown's left knee go down out of bounds before he makes the catch? And to me, it looks like it does. Great effort, but watch his left knee down. Ball's not there yet, but he's already out of bounds. As great of an effort as that was, ruled a catch on the field. I think maybe the fans in attendance see it the same way. Otherwise, you usually see it. They're playing it on the replay board. Usually hear a pretty enthusiastic response. It's kind of ambiguous right now for the fans. Heck of an effort by Rattler to extend that play. We've seen him scramble a little bit in this game. He scrambled more. They had one QB design run in this game. But oftentimes, he scrambles to throw. Seven of his touchdowns this year by Spencer Rattler were when he was pressured.
The receiver was out of bounds when he caught the ball, so they complete pass. The third and five at the South Carolina 48-yard line. Punt to start on the snap.
And again, one more look. Shane Beamer wants to talk to Jeff about it.
You see, watch his left knee. Left knee is down. Ball has not yet arrived. That's a good job by the replay booth. We're returning that one.
South Carolina's just 35% on the season on third down, and they're 0-5 so far tonight. Big story of the first half. Rattler's facing pressure, and he can't get away. A jailbreak blitz by Barrett Carter, forcing a punt. Came back last week after the injury, you'd never know it.
Here he is. Here's Carter. He's just going to come off the edge and run out of blockers. He brings six. Anderson went to the strong side, to the right side of the formation. Nobody left for Carter. Nowhere to go for Spencer Rattler on that one.
Ankle injury that he was dealing with. Preseason All-American coming into the season after 5.5 sacks last year. That's just his third of the season. You might hear the commissioner call his name in the first round next April. Coming up at halftime, you can watch the live performance of the Mighty Sound of the Southeast on SEC Network Plus. Start streaming now on the ESPN app. 13-7, Clemson leading South Carolina. That's the 40th sack allowed by the Gamecocks this year. As Stinch told you in the open of the broadcast, offensive line issues have been a big problem for the Gamecocks all season. It's a short punt by Kroger, and Green will field that. Just a 38-yard punt. Clemson does not have any timeouts left, and they do get the football first in the second half.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see, you know, how aggressive Clemson is right here with their play calling. You think that there's a chance, you know, maybe you pop a run here on this first down, that you stand on the gas. Otherwise, see if you can't get out of the half. South Carolina does have a time. They can't stop the clock one time. But as you mentioned, they'll double up on these possessions. Get the ball first in the third quarter.
Klubnik almost had that picked off as he threw it right at Stone Blanton.
Yeah, talk of Hemingway right in the middle, does a good job of kind of reading the quarterback eyes. You don't often say that about a nose tackle. Hey, read the quarterback's eyes, would you? And you can see he's coming at it. You see Hemingway jump. Kind of mistimed his jump, but still got that big hand up.
Tonka with the deflection. They go to the ground. Shipley goes to the ground past the 30 as Debo Williams tackles him. almost a 3 second difference between play clock and game clock here, and Clemson looks like they're going to be careful with this one.
We've seen it in this game. That ball has been in the air, and there have been several opportunities where it could have gone the other way. We've already seen it once. He's going to milk this clock all the way down and just play for the half.
On third and seven, Shipley. Nope, Klubnik keeps it. Breaks tackles, gets to midfield. And that will be 1 second left in the half. Again, Clemson does not have any timeouts. So don't believe they can get this play off. And they won't even try. This is the first time that Clemson had the lead after the first quarter in their last seven games. And they have the lead going to the half. Just a reminder, they haven't lost to a team with a losing record in 13 years. They lead their arch rival Gamecocks 13-7. As they go to the locker room, they do get the football to start the second half kick.
Well, the fireworks started early in this one, that's for sure. Clemson able to stun South Carolina with that scoop and score. You follow that up with a pick on the very first play of the next possession.
And Alyssa's with Dabo.
Coach, how has your defense been able to be so effective tonight?
Well, we struggled early on. They popped the quarterback draw on one long run. Good long drive. You know, they did a good job on third down and fourth down a couple of times, but we settled in here this last part of the second quarter, so now we just got to compliment them a little bit with the offense.
What do you need to see more of from your offense in the second half?
We've got to get that run game going. We're going to get the run game going and just, you know, make some of the plays that are there. We've had a couple plays there. We just hadn't made them.
Thank you, Coach.
Dabo Swinney, the winningest coach in Clemson history, trying to beat the Gamecocks for a fifth straight time in Columbia. Let's go to the studio now with Dari Noko. You're watching SEC Saturday Night, presented by T-Mobile 5G Home Internet. Fantastic venue here at Williams-Brice Stadium. Look at the atmosphere here live. As we start the second half, Clemson leads the Gamecocks 13-7. And boy, did Dabo Swinney's defense come out swinging tonight. You get two turnovers in under a minute. South Carolina has punched back. Both offenses struggling.
Yeah, you know, it's interesting because Dabo Swinney said they played championship caliber defense all season long. Boy, did they prove it early in this game. Really, both defenses have played relatively well. Offenses have struggled. Quarterbacks have not been able to get that passing game going. Really, when we've seen the ball in the air, it's been dangerous. It's gone the other way or nearly gone the other way. Some missed interception opportunities. Obviously, Clemson with the takeaway. The scoop and score on the second play of the game has really been the defining moment so far in this contest through two quarters.
Before the game, Dabo Swinney was asked, what's there left to play for? He said, everything, beating Carolina. Carolina, meanwhile, wants to play another game. They have to win this one to get to six wins. At last glance, there were five and six teams. If all five of them win, it'll be 82 six-plus win teams. If not, James Madison and Jacksonville State could be waiting in the wings. Mitch Jeter to Will Shipley. It goes past him, and Clemson starts first on offense in the third quarter, up 13-7, just 121 total yards, and Cade Klubnik only threw for 32 yards. But Clemson didn't turn it over, and they possessed the football almost 7 minutes longer than the Gamecocks did.
It really is the story. And you think about that second field goal. It was on an exceptionally short field. Clemson didn't move the ball very far. Took over it basically in midfield. Ended up kicking a field goal. Both offensive scores resulting in field goal attempts completed and made. But the offense has not been steadier in rhythm.
Maffa met immediately by Nick Emanwori.
The challenge for South Carolina defensively is to pick up where you left off effectively. Find a way to get the ball back to your offense quickly. Try to get a quick change, much like the way Clemson started this game when they got the first possession of the half.
I said Eamon Worry met Maffa. Maffa made him go three or four more yards. He picked five up there. Klubnik throws a one-on-one ball down there. Caught! What a catch! Tyler Brown! And the flag comes in as Jalen Kilgore was all over it.
Had the matchup that they like. We mentioned Kilgore, the freshman that was moved to that nickelback spot.
Pass interference, defense number 24. Penalties declined. Results of the play is a first down.
39 yards. He has 51 catches on the year.
Move the pocket. South Carolina's been able to get to Klubnik. Just kind of a half rollout. Post up and shoot.
Klubnik only had 32 yards passing in the first half. He got 39 on that play. And now he finds Brown again. Or excuse me, make that Sapp. That's Josh Sapp, the tight end, which is his fifth catch of the year.
This explosive plays in the passing game, that's probably the most glaring deficiency for this Clemson offense all season long. Coming into this game, 12th in their conference with explosive passes. This was the first one of 20 yards or more.
Josh's dad, Patrick, a great two-way player for Clemson back in the 90s. Klubnik pressured. And he'll just throw it away.
We've seen that a couple of times. As we mentioned, you know, you hit that shot downfield, it was on a half rollout. Just move that launch point. But to where Klubnik has been affected, the rush by South Carolina, which has not been an excellent pressure team throughout this season, but they have been able to affect Klubnik as a passer in this game.
Third and four from the Gamecocks 25. It's already the 11th third down that Clemson's had tonight. Converted half of them so far. And Klubnik throws. Incomplete. He's looking for Randall. Marcellus Dial was there.
Excellent coverage by Dial. Step for step with Randall. That time South Carolina only brought four. See the ball, great look from the old pylon cam. And once again, yet another field goal attempt.
Jonathan White's has been money. Made from 50 and from 49. This is from 42. Snap, good hold. White's. 3 for 3. Think of what this guy decided to do to come back against Florida State. Now that went, he hasn't blinked, and his team's up 9. Friday and Saturday, don't miss all the excitement and pageantry leading up to the 2023 SEC Championship game. There's no better place to get in on the action than with the SEC Nation crew at the Dr. Pepper SEC Fanfare. Head over to SEC Network for the fun at noon Eastern. Join Marty and McGee and the SEC Nation before the big game on Saturday. All the games that Alabama plays in Auburn are shake-your-head impossible finishes for both teams. And it was again this year. Meanwhile, Georgia beats Georgia Tech by 8. Of course, Clemson not in the ACC Championship game this year, but they will go to a bowl game in December at some point. Let's go down to the field and Alyssa.
Taylor, I caught up with head coach Shane Beamer coming out of halftime. I asked him what has to happen in the second half for his offense. He said, we have to protect better. We have to have a cleaner pocket. We've got to be able to move the pocket better. I also asked him about Mario Anderson and Trey Knox, two players who came off the field with injuries. He said, Mario's good to go. Trey Knox dealing with that knee, but fighting through it. I thanked him. He ran away, came back and said, hey, by the way, we were down by more than this on the road last year at Clemson. We came back and won this one.
That's a good point. They were. Overcame a pick six. Jeremiah Trotter had in that game and won 31-30. Spencer Rattler had over 300 yards passing in that game. He only has 34 in this game. He tried to get it to Leggett there. Xavier only has 3 catches for 25 yards.
Been quiet for Leggett. You know, right away, though, first play call, Shane Beamer was talking about we need to move the pocket. more. So first things first, sprint him out a little bit. Unable to connect, though, to the gap.
As Alyssa was talking about, you see Trey Knox, who clearly is favoring that knee. By the way, South Carolina has it at 30 because Clemson was offsides on the kick. Anderson gets a couple. It's going to be another third down. One of the big stories in this game is the Gamecocks' inability to do anything on this play.
A little dust up there. Like it was Trotter and Margiulo exchanging pleasantries after Thanksgiving.
They're 0 for 6 on third down tonight against this stout Clemson defense.
And another long third to convert. We saw last week with North Carolina in the scramble game, Drake May was able to hurt this Clemson defense. Might have got a procedure penalty off the early clap.
False start. Offense. Position on. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Sounded like you said, Nick Gargiulo, the center.
It looked like Gargiulo was changing the protection. It didn't look like it was like he was rocking back in his stance.
So now third and 13 for Rattler.
You see Gargiulo is emphatically, you wonder if there's a cadence issue, because you see Jeremiah Trotter is right up over the ball, clearly yelling something.
False start. Offense on 51. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
So that's back to back. Watch Trotter. You see him? He's right over the ball. See him? So he yells something. So disconcerting signal. You don't see it called very often. Gargiulo immediately pleading the case.
On third and 18, Rattler's going down. Rukarororo was all over him. And it's another punt for the Gamecocks. That's his 12th career sack.
What we talk about, so here's Ororo right here. Clemson, oftentimes that time they bluff the fifth rusher. He's able to beat Ja'Kai Moore right on the edge. And Shane Beamer talked about a couple of things with Alyssa there, where he was saying, you know, look, we got to move the pocket. They tried. We got to protect better. It failed on back-to-back procedure penalties, no less.
Fifth punt of the night for Kai Kroger. Shipley and Green are back, and it'll be Green at the 43. Yard line. A lot of talk about the Clemson offense. This Clemson defense is still nationally great. With that touchdown for the Gamecocks, that's all that South Carolina's gotten from Dabo Swinney's defense tonight. Clemson is leading, limiting the Gamecocks to 79 total yards with 11 minutes to go in the third quarter. Clemson has not scored an offensive touchdown, but they do have three field goals from Jonathan White, so they have great field position again. Klubnik, he gets it out as Bam Martin Scott almost got home to him as he throws it to Brenningstuhl. Terrific junior tight end.
You said it though, Taylor. He narrowly gets this ball off. Bam Martin Scott was closing fast. Good job by Brenningstuhl hauling that one in tight coverage.
Just a 3-yard gain. And it's Maffa. Phil, first down run, stays on his feet. And they finally get him down in South Carolina territory. It's a pickup of 12.
That time, good job by Clemson up front, covering up all the box defenders. Linebackers covered up at the second level.
Hoffa's more than doubled his career rushing totals as a junior. Quick pass, it's thrown to Sapp, and Sapp gets inside the 40 for his second catch of the night.
Kind of spreading that ball all the way to the boundary, forcing the defenders to play sideline to sideline. As you see South Carolina substituting that defensive front, trying to keep those guys fresh. Clemson able to get the ground game going a little bit, open up some of those run extension plays on these quick passes at the line of scrimmage.
Second and six to Maffa. First down again. That ball will be spotted near the 30.
A quiet first half by the tight ends. Only the one target. And they've got three catches in this quarter. Getting that ground game going a little bit. Now Maffa and Shipley both in the formation.
Those three guys that are ready for the ball to be snapped have combined for 24 carries and 113 rushing yards. It's Klubnik this time. Debo Williams on the stop.
Gone to that a couple of times in this game, trying to see if you can get the defenders to fly out of the box, bluff that quick throw to the boundary, or to the perimeter rather. You've got Maffa and Shipley, as we've already seen them. They'll come out of the backfield and make plays for you.
See Garrett Riley in that purple sweatshirt over there on the sidelines, the offensive coordinator. Lincoln's little brother, of course, Lincoln loves to throw it. Garrett's loved to run it this year with these guys. Fake to Shipley. Klubnik wants to throw to the end zone. And Brown and Eamon Worry, it's intercepted. Eamon Worry and Brown are still fighting for the ball, but the official said Nick won it.
Eamon Worry has position. If anything, it's offensive PI trying to fight back to that ball. Eamon Worry was underneath it.
Interception, he got a touchback. Timeout.
Flag, of course, did not come out, as you mentioned. The officials explain, ruling on the field, interception and a touchback. We talked about Nick Eamon Worry. 6'3". Boy, he used every inch of it to come up with that turnover.
Sophomore from Irmo, South Carolina, with a phenomenal effort for his second interception of the season. South Carolina is 10-0 in the last 2 years at home when they force a turnover. Nick Eamon Worry just picked off Cade Klubnik, and Spencer Rattler has it. At his own 20, he'll step up, he'll run, and he'll get a few down to Alyssa.
Beamer telling us this week he made an even bigger deal about winning the turnover margin, talking about some of Clemson's issues protecting the football, especially when they go on the road. He said in October, we didn't win a game. We didn't force a turnover. In November, they've won every single game and have forced a turnover in every one.
Mario Anderson met by a couple of Clemson defenders in the backfield. It was Peter Woods who first got to him. Then it was Barrett Carter. It's a loss of two.
Yeah, right now Clemson is winning the line of scrimmage. Not only getting penetration on these passing downs, able to get upfield quickly, rushing the passer. You know, they can do it with numbers, but they're also doing it with just defeating blocks right now.
Look at this third down. They hadn't converted one yet. Gamecocks only have 80 total yards in the game. Rattler stands in there, and there's a complete ball to Simon, and the first third down conversion of the night.
Rattler has time. He's an accurate passer. He drills this ball into Simon. Clean enough pocket to work in for the first time in a long time for the passer of South Carolina. Let's see.
Timeout for equipment repair.
Something's going on with the chains, it looks like, on the Clemson sideline.
Of course, the Gamecocks, first game of the year, had that issue with the chain gang coming out for halftime on time.
The fans don't like it, of course. South Carolina was trying to go fast, had to stop. Chain gang was all hung up on something over there.
Clemson's defense has been the story tonight, forcing two turnovers and limiting Spencer Rattler, but he finally converts on a third down. They've also been bottling up Mario Anderson, who's been going backwards lately. Barrett Carter, what a performance.
Couple of linebackers playing off one another. Jeremiah Trotter was the one that got upfield and had Mario Anderson slam on the brakes. Look at this drive chart. Here's show that to Shane Beamer. You see the challenges that they've had. They had the one good drive, aided by the roughing the passer, get a couple of nice runs. Otherwise, it has been really tough sledding. But as you mentioned, got the first third down conversion.
Second and 12, Rattler underneath. And that is caught by Tyshawn Russell. Russell, just with his fifth catch of the year, is a crosser there. It'll be third down again for the Gamecocks as Nate Wiggins tackled him.
Clemson effectively conceding that throw. It'll force this third and long. Anything underneath, we've seen Wiggins is as sure a tackler as there is on the field here tonight. Come up and report. Has been excellent after the catch. Seen Clemson align a couple of times where they show pressure in the middle and then bail out into coverage.
Rattler over the middle, incomplete. Leggett had it in his breadbasket, but Barnes was draping him. Fourth down.
A great play by Barnes. He gets his left hand in front of Leggett. They brought everybody. They bring six. Pretty good pickup. You see Barnes, that left hand out in front, ball a little bit behind. If it's out in front a little bit more, I'm still not sure he makes that play. Barnes all over Xavier Leggett.
South Carolina has negative yardage since the first quarter. It's a sixth straight punt for Kroger and the Gamecocks. It's a good one, and Green call for the fair catch at the 15. Let's get a studio update with Dari Noko.
All right, Taylor, it's time for our five-star play presented by Yellowwood, and there's no question as to what that play would be. Jalen Milroe to Isaiah Bond, fourth and goal from the 31, and Alabama with its own prayer at Jordan-Hare. Clearly answered for the Tide as they go to the title game against Georgia next week at 11-1. Yes.
Dari, we were watching it on the field before this one kicked, and Stinch immediately said, how on earth does Bond get behind the defense there?
Yeah, we've seen a similar play like that. Michael Johnson caught one from David Green back in the day. Same corner of the end zone.
Shipley doesn't get much. Jalen Kilgore is not out there, Alyssa.
Yeah, guys, he got hurt after that last drive. Came out of the injury tent with a bag of ice taped to his right hamstring. Typically, ice means you're done for the day.
Kawan Banks is out there playing the nickel right now. South Carolina, that'd be a big loss for defensive coordinator Clayton White that you see there with no hat in the middle, the headset on. Klubnik keeps it himself and busts it outside. First down, shoved out of bounds at the last second.
You think about that one big play that Clemson hit in this second half to Tyler Brown. Kilgore was in coverage. You'd like to think that if you're Clemson, you find a way to get that matchup again in the slot. Klubnik can kind of a half roll out to start this half to get him going in the passing game.
Given how solid he's been, Shipley and Maffa have been with running the football. I was a little surprised at that end zone throw on that last drive. Take the era of the football until they can stop it. Shipley gets up near the 30.
That's an interesting point, right? Run it in if you can. As we've mentioned a couple of times in this game, the ball's been in the air. It's been in jeopardy. The defenses have had chances to make plays on the ball. South Carolina has just the one takeaway, the one interception. They should have two, at least, in this game. Obviously, Clemson's already had success getting the ball back from the Carolina offense.
backfield, throw it to Shipley, and will get turned the corner up near the 35. Appears to be short.
Yep, he's right at the line to gain.
Stabo Sweeney, two national titles, four trips to that game, six playoff appearances, eight ACC titles, best winning percentage of any coach in ACC history, just under 80%. And boy, is he bullish about the future of this program with all the young players he has all over the field on a third and one. Maffa, first down, past the 40.
Nice surge by Clemson up front. Eye candy in the backfield. And yeah, bullish. He's handing out stock picks. Talking about people, if you're going to buy stock in any team, he's saying you buy it in Clemson right now. Expects it to be a fast riser.
12 straight 10-plus win seasons until this year. Still get to 9 if they win this game and win the bowl game. Maffa pushing the pile up past the 48. Dabo, the seventh longest tenured coach in college football. Remarkably, 16 years as a head coach at Clemson, but 21 years there in Clemson, South Carolina. And if he wins this game tonight, more Power 5 wins than any other coach since 2013, one more than Nick Saban.
Pretty remarkable run, and it's been marked by tremendously successful seasons.
Maffa just short of the first down, it appears, actually with the spot that could be right at it. See,
makes 11 if so of their 14 first downs. Not showing third, just short, have come on the ground.
There's a flag down. Would be a first down.
They're saying, I think it's a legal formation. Too many men in the backfield. Have a receiver up on the line of scrimmage. We're shy one.
The previous play made a first down. Illegal formation, more than five players, four players in the backfield. It's a 5-yard penalty, still first down.
I see, so instead of it being third and short on the previous play, it was first and 10. He did get enough yardage for the first down. And so now it's first and 15. Goes Maffa, in comes Shipley. Klubnik throws it, dropped by Sapp.
It's definitely an interesting sequence. South Carolina still trying to get explanation as to what happened. Officials are saying that even though it was marked as a third down and a play was run, it should have been a first down. Shane Beamer is observing that enthusiastically to the officials nearby. It was, procedurally, that was an interesting way to get there, that's for sure. Penalty on a third down, and it's first and 15. Regardless, second and 10 plus because of that procedure penalty.
Klubnik surveying, throws underneath, back to the original line of scrimmage. It's caught by Olsen, Pat Henry. No Sage Ennis in this game tonight. Backup tight end, and some guys like Sapp and Pat Henry that have not caught many balls on the season. Both make catches tonight. It is third and 10 for the Tigers here. As Fortune goes down. Donald missing last week due to team violations. Of course, his four career interceptions, had that pick six in the Gator Bowl. Shane Beamer's team last year desperately would love to win one more game and get back to a bowl game for the third consecutive season. If they do it, they're going to have to get the offense going against the Clemson Tigers. Clemson's defense has been sensational. Garrett Riley's offense refuses to stop possessing the ball.
No, they just hang on to it. And as you mentioned on that previous possession, take the air out of the ball as you see Shane Beamer still seeking clarity. He's saying we're sitting here on a third down. I feel certain he's revisiting the previous, what he thought was third down. And now the crowd's starting to get back into this game. Look at the end of the last play. Fortune, who was in on that tackle, but immediately, as he gets up anyway, was a bit shaken up. Looks like he's going to be all right. Conferring with his head coach, who I'm sure was very interested in his status and ability to finish this thing in the waning seconds here in the third quarter. A 9-point game. Lots of field goals. That's the difference in this one so far. Third down opportunity now for South Carolina defensively. They've got four designated rushers. Assuming none of these guys drop back into coverage. Look at that shift. The big guys go to the edges and the ends go inside.
Klubnik on third and 10. That is a good ball but dropped. Troy Stellato had it.
The ball stopped him, but he had it. Protection held up. Stellato's open over the middle, hits him right in the hands. You got to come up with that catch. We've said that a couple of times tonight. We haven't seen a ton of success in the passing game. We've seen some receivers letting down their quarterbacks on third downs. Think back to the Nick Harbor drop. There, a drop from Stellato.
And Swanson, who's been terrific, punting with Amarian Brown back there. It's a short punt. Brown fields it at the 15. That's the end of the third quarter. Clemson is 134-4, leading after three since 2015.
Coach, what has to happen for you guys to close this one out?
Well, we need to finish in the red zone right there. It was a tough turnover for us. Good play. Great play by their guy, but that was disappointing. You know, defense got to continue to hold up, keep them, win the field position battle. We've been winning that this half, so keep them pinned on the long field. Need to find another turnover, and then we got to finish here in the red zone one more time.
Thank you, Coach.
Okay. Boy, is his defense held up tonight. South Carolina just has one total yard since the first quarter and 94 for the game. Rattler running around, trying to buy time. He gets drilled as he got rid of it. And T.J. Parker crushed him. Second down.
Spencer Rattler gets absolutely planted right here. Boom. This kid has shown unbelievable toughness this season.
Freshman from Phoenix City, Alabama, has been fantastic. Think they had a 19-yard completion to Leggett, the first offensive play of the game. It's going to have a long touchdown drive in that quarter, but nothing since. Across the middle, incomplete at the feet of Brown. Third and 10.
Brown saying, oh, I was held. You know, we've talked about this coming into this game. Clemson, these DBs are tight in coverage. They stick and run. And they are physical as that ball arrives. You're not going to have some clean catch of the ball. Brown could not corral that one. Protection actually held up okay for Rattler on that throw.
On third and 10, Rattler trying to buy time. He's going to give it to Anderson. Anderson drops it. That'll be an incompletion. Rattler has had Tigers in his face all night. Parker was back there all over him again.
Another where Spencer Rattler just has to jump to try to get this ball out of there. Jeremiah Trotter once again encircling the protection forces Rattler up into a pocket that's collapsing into his lap. Man, T.J. Parker again dumping the quarterback of South Carolina. As you see Trotter on the sideline, this defense, as you mentioned, it has been stout. That doesn't even begin to describe it.
Kroger to Green. Green tackled immediately. And Clemson will start at their own 41-yard line, up 9 in the fourth quarter. Phenomenal performance by Wes Goodwin's Clemson defense tonight. Khalil Barnes already had a fumble recovery for a touchdown when he made that interception. Barrett Carter's been in the backfield all night. Ruka Rororo on Rattler there. Six tackles for loss, seven quarterback hurries. Bunch of knockdowns, 94 total yards for the Gamecock offense. And back to the ground go the Tigers and Phil Maffa. We mentioned Wes Goodwin and the job that his defense has done tonight. Maligned a bit last year. You take over for Brent Venables. How can you not be? I mean, yeah. The guy was a legend at Clemson, helping them win those two national championships. But Goodwin has significantly improved all parts of this defense.
It was a big challenge. You know, Dabo Swinney, when we were talking with him earlier, he said, that was my big challenge to the defense. We've got to be better. Pass defense especially. They have definitely been able to do that this season. Some young guys contributing, too.
Klupnik staying upright and getting a couple more. It'll be third and manageable after even worry. Finally gets Klupnik on the ground. Clemson has run it for over 150 yards on the night.
Third down, Shipley substituting in the backfield. Seen him a number of times targeted out of that backfield. Gives them a receiving option on a third and call it three here. We've also seen Klubnik where they'll blow Shipley out of the backfield, see if they can get the defense to shift. And Clemson wants to talk about
it. Time out. Clemson.
Third and three, but they'll talk this over. Tuesday at 7 Eastern, it's a matchup for the ACC-SEC Men's Basketball Challenge featuring Notre Dame and South Carolina, followed by Boston College and Vanderbilt. Wednesday night at 9:15 Eastern, catch it on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. It's been fun to watch these two conferences go at it in all sports, but especially in basketball the last few years. Of course, the football teams have four matchups today. Kentucky surprising Louisville earlier today.
Unreal.
Florida State hanging on to dear life against Florida right now. Georgia's up 11 on Georgia Tech and Clemson up 9 in this big rivalry matchup.
It's definitely been an interesting day amongst the rivalry games that are interconference between SEC and ACC. Obviously, Kentucky set the tone from an SEC perspective earlier. Tight games elsewhere, though. On the third down, we saw this, as I mentioned, they blow Shipley out, and then Klubnik ends up on the QB draw.
Maffa straight ahead, short. Jay Sanders and O'Donnell Fortune.
That time, instead of having Klubnik take it, they hand it to Maffa. Mentioned shy, and they're leaving the offense on the field. There was no hesitation here. It still remains a 9-point game. This game is within reach from South Carolina's perspective.
And just trying to draw them off or truly going for this on a fourth and one.
Like Jordan Strong, they nearly got a Gamecock defender to jump. I think surely that's what's happening here. Yeah.
Play game, offense, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
Certainly makes more sense to just take the penalty instead of burning another timeout there. Garrett Riley's offense will return to the sidelines. 34 years old, of course, helped TCU go to the national championship game last year. Without him, TCU went 5-7 this year.
Yeah, different team this year for TCU, that's for sure. I mean, we thought they were something other than what we've learned them to be, that's for sure. And TCU, and of course, Riley's had to acclimate to this conference as well. And as you mentioned earlier, Taylor, a lot of guys, especially at skill positions, that have not been available. Wide receivers, maybe most notably. Offensive linemen as well for Clemson that are no longer available.
Hayden Swanson in again with Amarian Brown inside his 10. Brown races up and fields it at the 15.
Fingertips catch.
Fingertip catch indeed. 11:54 to go. Can the Gamecock offense get something done on this Clemson defense?
SEC Saturday Night is presented by T-Mobile 5G Home Internet, connecting homes across the SEC.
Old Jerry Butler, that first grab down there, and then, of course, the big play in 2000. Carolina comes back in 2010 to get the win in the middle of the five-game Spurrier winning streak. Alshon Jeffrey, the best season any South Carolina receivers ever had. Leggett's had the second best. They can't find him tonight. There he is, over the 30-yard line on a downfield pass for the Gamecocks, 17 yards.
Well, we're just saying during the break, South Carolina's got to do something to jumpstart their offense. You got to get something going. It's been so hard to keep their quarterback clean enough to get a route downfield. And even then, as you see Dowell Loggins on the right, Wes Goodwin on the left. This match all game long. It has been a challenge for the Gamecocks offensively.
It's the longest pass since the first quarter, the first play to Leggett. Rattler has time. Hadn't had much of that tonight. And he finds Leggett on consecutive plays. And Xavier breaks a tackle and gets a first down.
Well, I'll tell you what stands out when you look at Xavier Leggett on the hoof. When you're down there next to him, that guy is stacked. I mean, he is put together. That lower body's got some power, and it's not just speed. As you saw there, the would-be tackle from Barnes, he just shed it. Picked up another 4 or 5 yards on the boundary.
He's doubled his career catches and tripled his yards and touchdowns in this season after 4 years. Rattler has time, incomplete. Nice play on the ball by Avion Terrell as Luke Doty was the intended receiver.
You can see South Carolina trying to loosen things up in the passing game. Terrell's excellent corner. He is a young player. Man, that last week versus North Carolina, he stepped up big, physical as the ball arrives. Another breakup.
Big brother AJ has to love that. Rattler tried to get it out to Anderson, but threw it too far. It'll be third down. For more on Terrell, let's go to Alyssa.
Taylor, you mentioned his brother AJ, of course, who also played at Clemson. He learned a ton from him. Dabo Swinney was talking to us, as you guys mentioned earlier in this game, about how high he is on this freshman class, and Avion is just a great example of why. Dabo said he doesn't look like a freshman, he doesn't act like a freshman. I find him in the facility until 10 p.m. and later studying film.
He had his first start against Notre Dame, Alyssa, and his first interception against Georgia Tech. Rattler tries to throw a little bubble pass again. Anderson is flagged down. Nice open field tackle by Barnes.
Great job by Barnes. He's in the coverage in the slot over Leggett.
Surprised by this. Gamecock fans want Shane Beamer to go for this. It's fourth down. 10 minutes to go, down 9. Certainly Kai Kroger could throw it. Kroger's 7 of 8 in his career passing. But he's punting. Green with another fair catch at the 10-yard line. Tigers looking for another win over their rivals. You're watching SEC Saturday Night presented by T-Mobile 5G Home Internet. Terrific crowd in Williams-Brice Stadium tonight. Look at that. Season high, 80,172. We were here for that Florida game. Gators down double digits in the fourth quarter, came back to shock South Carolina. And who would have thought that would have been Florida's last win of the year? Shipley gets past the 20, up to the 24.
I was just going to say, for South Carolina, it's a big opportunity. You punt the football away, you can keep Clemson pinned down. You heard Coach Sweeney talking about it earlier. They're winning the field position battle. There's Shipley able to get them out of a hole. A great run. Clemson, that was their, was anyway, their worst starting field position of the game. Able to kind of let them out of the hole there.
Another Shipley run. He gets past the 30-yard line. We were visiting with Dabo the other day, and he was talking about Thanksgiving. He has a huge Thanksgiving feast at the facility where all family of players are invited to attend. Did that on Wednesday, and then Thursday ate dinner with all those Sweeney boys and his wife, stringing lights on Thursday night, getting all the lights up for the holidays. And he is just loving being a part of this rivalry. He has so much respect for Steve Spurrier, still calls him a very close friend. And as Shipley gets another first down, he went on and on with the stench on the call about how he feels about the entire Beamer family, how Frank really took him under his wing when he first became the coach at Clemson. And Frank, of course, was the coach at Virginia Tech and went out of his way to be friendly to him. And Dabo said he's been friends with Shane for a long time. As soon as Shane got the job in South Carolina, he called Dabo and had a conversation that meant a lot to Dabo. And Dabo says, you know, when we go on the rubber chicken circuit around the state for these speaking engagements, first thing I do is I go find Shane. I love just talking ball with him. He said, you don't have to hate the guy on the other sideline. Maffa, nope, Klubnik keeps it. Back in 2011, the ACC championship, that first one that Dabo got, was against Shane's dad, Frank. Dwayne Allen, look at that big tight end.
Ah.
He was a beast. Sammy Watkins making this catch from Taj Boyd. Clemson wins by four touchdowns, and there's Frank and Dabo on the field 13 years ago.
I loved how Dabo said, I walk into the room with all the coaches and I see like Ralph Friedgen, Al Monroe. Gosh, that's not the warmest greeting yeah. parties, a bunch of curmudgeons.
Frank went out of his way to change that. Maffa gets hit
nice
in the backfield.
Play.
Good play made by TJ Sanders. But yeah, Frank and Cheryl are here tonight. Glad they're doing well. Got to spend some time with the grandkids in the last few days. It's 3rd and 13 for Shane Beamer's defense. It needs another stop and needs the offense to score in a hurry.
Looks like Clemson will go with the empty backfield. We've seen South Carolina really kind of just committed three to the rush. Early on in this game, they were able to get there. Now they've got a four down lineman to try to get after the passer here.
Klubnik swings it out to Shipley. Makes one man miss, but Stone Blanton stays with him, and it'll be fourth down.
Swing the ball out there to Shipley. Well shy of it. A security blanket in that regard. Stone Blanton did a good job coming up. And the challenge is for South Carolina is, once again, they'll have to drive the long field, barring anything unforeseen here on the punt.
Gamecocks use that first timeout, down 9, about to get the ball back. Gamecocks had a couple of disastrous plays in the first quarter. They were only down three at the first, six at the break, nine at the end of three, and that's the score now, 16-7. Number 24 Clemson only made one mistake tonight. Klubnik throwing an interception that Nick Emanwori picked off. Aiden Swanson ready to punt it back to Brown. And look at the 10 Gamecocks on the line. They've blocked four punts this year. And they almost got to that one. South Carolina, again, backed up with poor field position. Let's go down to Alyssa.
Guys, as the offense was on the bench before taking the field here on this next drive, Shane Beamer came over to the offensive line, came over to Spencer Rattler, walked over to his wide receivers, and got in the faces of each and every one of them, pointed over to the scoreboard at the amount of time left in this game, and at the score. 16-7, very much in reach for this South Carolina team, looking for some energy from his guys.
Well, Alyssa, Spencer has had some huge wins. First ever win over Texas A&M. First win against Kentucky in many years. Last year, beat two top 10 teams in a row, beating Tennessee and Clemson. Of course, the win last week against Kentucky was big. This one might take the cake if the Gamecocks could come back, given the way this one's gone, with 5:57 to go.
Maybe take a shot here if protection holds up.
He wants to. Instead, flushed out and running and out of bounds past the 20-yard line. It'll be a first down, 10 yards rushing for Rattler. He had 360 yards passing in this game last year. He has 86 tonight.
It's pretty remarkable. I mean, when you think about the way this game started, right out of the gate, hit that shot to the dead, and then it has been quiet ever since. That pick was a dampener.
Trying to find somebody, throws. Brown caught that ball over Wiggins.
I don't know how that ball dropped in there to Brown. You know, Wiggins is probably 4 inches taller than Brown. It goes just past his outstretched arm. Nice concentration by Brown to bring that one in.
9-yard pickup. Anderson starts, stops, first down. Past the 40 for Mario. Flag does come in, though.
Holding. Offense number one. It's a 10-yard penalty. Second down.
That's the hard part. You know, you're just trying to pick up a yard. So when you do the redirect and he bounces out, the Knox has just got, you got to let him go. Trey Knox is on the backside. He's sealing the edge defender. He's got his hands outside. As soon as that defender tries to disengage and start flailing those arms, you got to let go. It's just like when a quarterback scrambles. You could have a defensive end locked up. As soon as he tries to escape outside, you got to let that guy go.
Second and 11 now for Rattler. Leggett drags the defender Terrell past, past the 30 up to the 31. So it'll be third and short.
What an effort by Leggett after that catch. Just, you said it, drag Terrell.
After Leggett gets him close, then Anderson gets him the first down.
It's kind of like deja vu all over again. With the holding penalty, go back, have to hustle to get it back up to where it was close. Anderson comes out, Joyner comes in.
Joyner in there now. Rattler just has to throw it into the bench. Pressure by Xavier Thomas. Senior that was an All-American 4 years ago. Foot injury. But he has not been hampered by anything tonight for Wes Goodwin.
He's had a heck of a game. Got upfield right now to affect that throw from Spencer Rattler. But they have been challenging Clemson downfield. These routes, Rattler had to scramble on the first down.
Thomas. Pressuring again as Rattler tried to get it to Harbor. Incomplete. Third down. I wonder how many graduate classes Xavier Thomas has taken. He graduated 3 years ago. He's been out there Bates playing forever for Clemson.
His doctorate, shouldn't he, by now? Doctor of something. Pass rush.
Tyler Davis, Rukarororo, and Xavier Thomas have played a whole lot of football together. On the 3rd and 10, out of the backfield, it's Braswell. And he's tackled by R.J. Mickens. And that'll set up a fourth down.
No other decision to make right there. Braswell comes in for Anderson just for the one play. He did not hesitate to get to the top of the formation. Right up here.
Rattler flushed on 4th and 3. Can't get, well, he gets rid of it. It's caught, but short by Doty. Turnover on downs. It was T.J. Parker that was all over Rattler, and he forces that turnover on downs, and Clemson gets the ball back again.
Well, he wanted Leggett. They tried to move him out. Parker able to get loose once again. See Ja'Kai Moore kind of trailing in the background. And once again, protection just not enough for South Carolina to execute. We knew it was going to be a challenge coming into this game. Watching the way Clemson's able to play defensively and how many defenders they can commit to the line of scrimmage to defend the run and to rush. And you're looking at a lot of one-on-ones.
They've been the story of the game. They have the only touchdown Clemson's defense does for Clemson tonight. Fumble recovery for a touchdown. Shipley bouncing off Gamecocks.
That's a good point, Taylor. Yeah, I mean, the Clemson defense, and Dabo Swinney said, they were playing championship level. No, he said, they're good enough to where we could be undefeated this season.
Well, you think of it, all the turnovers in the red zone against Duke. The Miami game, you have a double-digit lead. Three turnovers against NC State. Florida State game, a missed field goal with under 2 minutes to go in the game. Well, the defense has held up for 12 games for Dabo.
And the place kicking has held up for at least one game. Well, it came in handy tonight.
Hoffa inside the 30, first down for Clemson, and South Carolina can only stop it two more times. Yeah, White's has been a huge story. You missed that 49 and or the 50-yarder. It could still be a one-possession game, but he comes in, drills the 50-yarder.
I think that's fired up.
And the 49-yarder. And then made the one from 42 as well. This is a heck of a night for the White's family. What happened earlier in the year and all the misses that the kickers have had this year for Clemson. This is a heck of an example of sticking with it. Maffa sticks with it down inside the 20, and Clemson can just about run the clock out. Our friend Mark Slaybaugh Stinch has the Tigers going to either the Holiday or the Gator Bowl after an 8-4 regular season. Timeout called by the Gamecocks with 1:39 left.
Did he throw out a potential opponent in either one of those?
I believe he had North Carolina playing Clemson in the Gator Bowl, but I don't know if that included tonight's result. The Wolfpack putting a whipping on the Tar Heels over on ACC Network tonight.
What's that? Wow.
39-20. Score in that one, but lots of time left. Meanwhile, let's take a look at today's high-speed play brought to you by T-Mobile 5G Home Internet. It is the second play of the game, Stinch.
High-speed play happened fast for all of us. Well, only the second play of the game after big completion to Leggett. Will Barnes is there to pick up the backwards pass to Xavier Leggett. That was the only time that Clemson found itself in the end zone. Now they're under 2 minutes to play and now in the red zone. But it has been a quiet night from a scoring standpoint for both offenses.
Cox will call their last timeout. For South Carolina, some heartbreaking losses along the way this year. You think of the North Carolina game, they have the lead in the second half of that game, couldn't put it away in game one. Have the Dogs on the ropes, up 14-3 in the second half, and Athens up double digits on the Gators here in the middle of October. Played great football in November, beating Jacksonville State, Vanderbilt, last week beating Kentucky, but barring a miracle, they'll finish the season 5-7 and go into the offseason after this one.
They got some guys, they got to get back healthy, there's no doubt. And certainly impacted the trajectory of their season right out of the gate. You know, coming out of spring, no Jalen Nichols, offensive line never really fielded the way they would have intended that lineup to look. And obviously you got guys that go down with injury, some guys that seemingly could have made their way back that just couldn't find a way to take the field anymore for South Carolina. And then you see others that battled through it, the Spencer Rattlers, the Xavier Leggetts, especially on the offensive side of the ball. You could tell that clearly those injuries early in the season compromised them. Clemson, too, they've had to endure quite a bit of injury.
Second and 7, it's Moffa. Gamecocks cannot stop the clock, as it'll be third down for Clemson. So much respect for both of these fan bases and the way that they support their teams. You think of it, Clemson has its most disappointing season in over a decade. The atmosphere last week against the Tar Heels, week before that against Georgia Tech and Notre Dame, phenomenal over there in the upstate. And the Gamecock fans, the last few weeks, the atmosphere last week against Kentucky and tonight was electric. They love their football in this state.
Well, Alyssa captured it really well in the open. I mean, this is no pro sports in this state. This is the most passionate outpouring for their fans, for both schools, respectively. And boy, they showed up tonight. This was an unbelievable atmosphere to start this game.
You know, there's few rivalries like Oklahoma, Oklahoma State, who senselessly are going away. And I love this. Graham Neff, the athletic director at Clemson, Ray Tanner and I have talked about it. We will continue to play the game, period. However, the landscape continues to change. No conversations otherwise, no mindset otherwise. I love that. It means too much to the people. And, you know, credit to the great state of Washington. Unbelievable game there today. Washington wins the cup in overtime against Washington State. They're going to keep playing that game even though they won't be in the same conference anymore. These in-state games, they mean so much to all the people in the state.
Yeah, they matter. I mean, these rivalries matter. It's better for the sport to continue to play these games. Graham Neff's a Parkview grad. He's a smart guy. He understands.
It's your high school, man. Shipley can put the game away with a first down run, and he will. And he's out of bounds at the 5. There, Kawan Banks makes the tackle. But victory formation for Dabo Swinney and the Tigers now if they want to. You're saying my bad because the clock isn't still running, but the Gamecocks can't stop it.
There's no bad there. Did it right. Now you're victory formation.
We have seen in recent weeks, there are a lot of coaches who keep trying to tack on points.
Yeah.
This shows a lot of respect between the two coaching staffs here. Dabo will improve to 9-6 in this rivalry. Think about it. Spencer Rattler just 112 yards passing. South Carolina only at 57 yards rushing. Just a total performance from the Clemson defense tonight from start to finish. And they win the game 16-7 over Shane Beamer, whose team finishes the season 5-7. Clemson is in the top 25, 8-4, going to a 13th bowl game that will be decided a week from tomorrow.
You see the two coaches there that were met at midfield, Kate Klubnik and his fellow Clemson Tigers, able to put a punctuation exclamation mark at the end of this one.
And Alyssa's with Dabo.
Coach, you said earlier this season to buy stock in this team. What does that stock look like right now?
Well, I'll tell you what, this is a hard-fought game, you know, to come in this environment and win the turnover margin. That's been the key for us this year. Wish we could have finished a couple more. We had some opportunities that we didn't finish, but really played our defense all night. And just proud of those guys. And we just kind of called it and played to it. And we made some big plays. Obviously, the score to start the game was huge. But really, just happy for our fans. And I got a great appreciation for Coach Beamer and his guys and how hard they competed. And we're just thankful and blessed to win it.
Speaking of the way you started the game, Khalil Barnes, one of those young guys who stepped up this season. What have you learned about your freshman class this year?
We got some ballers, man. We got some dudes in that group, and we got more on the way. So we really like our roster. And these guys are going to be around here for a while. But, man, Khalil Barnes had a heck of a day once again. He's had a great year. But just happy again for our fans.
Let's do it, man.
Speaking of.
There he is right there.
We got the trophy back.
We got the trophy back, man. You know we came up
there. Yes, sir. This is what we do, man.
Congrats, Coach.
Thank you.
We'll celebrate that with your team, Coach Sweeney. It's the last Clemson win without an offensive touchdown was in 2014 against Louisville. They didn't have one tonight, but they get the win against the Gamecocks 16-7. I want to thank our terrific staff here in the booth, Daniel and Margie in the truck, Adam, Nick, Haley, and everybody with our team tonight all season long. Kevin and Russ do a great job here in the booth. For the fantastic Alyssa Lang and my great friend Matt Stinchcomb, I'm Taylor Zarzer. So long from the state championship of South Carolina. Clemson beats the Gamecocks 16-7. SEC football final is coming up next in the studio. And our friends Dari Noka, Chris Storing, and Benjamin Watson have you covered. So long from Columbia.